हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ उमैर हसन एंड यू आर वाचिंग CSS CSF लेक्चर सीरीज़। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेशो, दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। एंड व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन रेशो इज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कॉन्सेप्ट एंड हाउ टू डिवाइड अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, अ सर्टन क्वान्टिटी इन अ गिवन रेशो। देन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम रियल लाइफ प्रॉब्लम्स on the concept of ratio and ratio involving three quantities. Well, subscribe the channel, the best CSS CSF preparation you are going to have on this channel. I will be sharing lectures on the science section as well, but let me go through this CSS ability section. First of all, subscribe the channel. If you want to access my previous lectures, go into the playlist and you will have all of that. What is ratio? Ratio is comparison, and we used to do comparison in our day-to-day life. Comparison of marks, you ask about your friend how much you got in your essay and how much I got in my essay. You know, marks to marks comparison, ratio. Comparison of height of my brother and me. Comparison. I'm comparing my height with my brother. No, that is comparison of same quantities. This is very important. Next lesson will be about rate. Rate is comparison also, but of different quantities. Ratio is comparison of same quantities. My weight compared to my brother's weight. Comparison, again comparison, but what? Weight to weight, same quantities. Height to height, same quantity. Marks to marks, same quantities, and so many comparisons are available. So ratio is a comparison, and basically if we have two quantities, same kind of, one is A and the other is B, then how to express a ratio? We express them as A ratio B, and that is equal to A over B, right? So this is how you are going to express two quantities in ratio form, and this is the general concept of ratio. So let us discuss a couple of examples. Now let us take an example first. So this is a simple example of ratio. There are 17 boys and 19 girls in a class. Find the ratio of part number 1, number of boys to number of girls. Well, that means number of boys ratio number of girls. That mean how many boys do we have? 17 ratio how many girls do we have? 19. So 17 over 19, this is the required ratio, number of boys to number of girls. But look at part number 2, it's number of girls to number of boys. No, this is important. No, they have interchanged the quantities. Number of girls are first. Number of girls to number of boys. Well, that is number of girls ratio number of boys. And we have 19 girls ratio 17 boys, which is 19 over 17. So this is how you are going to write the two same type of quantities in a ratio. Take another example. Take another question. The number of female participants, the ratio of number of female participants to number of male participants in a party is 4:9. Okay. If there are 30 more male participants than female participants in the party, find total number of participants in that party. So we have been given the ratio of male to female participants, and we need to find total number of participants with the condition that males are 30 more than females. Now let us start the question. We don't know the number of total participants that is to be obtained. So number of total participants, they are not known, let them x. Let number of total participants, they are x. Well that is you can find female number of female participants, number of female participants, well they are 4, the ratio given for the females divided by total parts of ratio 9 plus 4 13, multiply by total number of participants, that is 4 over 13 x. Total number of participants, they are supposed to be x. Similarly, find number of male participants. Well, they are, the ratio for them is 9 for male. Total parts in the ratio are 13, 9 plus 4, 13 into total number of participants are x. So this is number of male participants. We have been told that males are 30 more than female. Well, that means there is a difference of 30 participants. There is a difference of 30 persons. Males are 30 more than female. That means if you will find the difference between number of male and number of females, the answer will be 30, because males are 30 more. So the difference between males and females, the difference in the number is 30. So number of male participants minus number of female participants, well that is 30, because males are 30 more, so difference is 30. Number of male participants are 9 over 13 x. Number of female participants are 4 over 13 x equal to 30. You need to find x, because we need to find total number of participants, which are x. You can take LCM over here. LCM is 13. So that is 9x minus 4x. 9x minus 4x. If the LCM is 13, here we have 13, here you have 13. So 9x minus 4x will remain as they are. You will multiply 13 with 30. 9x minus 4x is 5x. 30 into 13. 390. You can find the value of x from here. That is 390 over 5. Well, 5 7 times 35. 5 8 times 40. Total number of participants are 78. X is 78. That is total number of participants. The next one is, we have to divide a particular amount, share rupees 100, between Nasir and Jamshed, and the formula for DVN is given. The ratio is given. We have to divide rupees 100 according to this ratio. Well, the total parts in the ratio are 7 plus 3, 10. So let's divide 100 into 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. I will be dividing 100 in 10 parts. The total is 100. Now, out of 10 parts, 3 parts are for Nasir, while the rest 7 parts are for Jamshed. Well, Nasir has then 10, 10, 10, 30, and Jamshed has no 70. Now, this is one of the way diagrammatically you can use the concept of ratio like this. And well, that is dividing a quantity in a given ratio. Now, you can do it by the other process as well. Now, Nasir's share, that is equal to how much parts are there for Nasir in the ratio, 3 parts, while total parts of the ratio are 10. into total amount which is 100. So the answer is 30, the same. While Jamshed's share is, how much parts are there for Jamshed? 7, total parts are 10, 7 plus 3, 10 into total quantity is 100, which is to be divided. So that is 70. In this way, you can divide a particular quantity according to a given ratio in parts. And the last one for this lecture is this one, ratio of three quantities. I have discussed real life example, three quantities. X ratio Y is 11 ratio 8, Y ratio Z is 6 ratio 7. You need to find X ratio Y ratio Z. Well, X ratio Y is 11 ratio 8, you can write it like this. Y ratio Z is 6 ratio 7, you can write it like this. Now, you have to observe that the middle one is Y, and this number should be same here as well as here. Its value should be same because it is in the middle, it is to be shared with X as well as with Z. It should be same value. Here you have got Y equal to 8, here Y is 6. You can make value of Y same at both these places. If I want to make this number and this number same, well, you can do it. 24 is a multiple of 8, 24 is a multiple of 6. 11 into 3, 8 into 3. Well, I want to convert this 8 into 24, and 8 will be converted into 24 by multiplying by 3. If you are going to multiply something in the denominator, you have to multiply this in the numerator. It will now become 33 over 24. Whereas Y over Z, you can convert 6 into 24 if you multiply 6 by 24, and if you are multiplying something in the numerator, you have to multiply that in the denominator as well. So Y over Z is 24 over 28. Now you can see that we have got same value of Y. Y is 24. Now X ratio Y ratio Z is, X is 33, Y is 24, Z is 28. So this is the solution for ratio involving three quantities. So you have bundle of question, ample of question on ratio. You can practice as much as you can. These are the basic concepts in the ratio. Keep watching. Thank you so much.